fire springs forth. What bile does bubble? The black moon swings, and the sky stirs treble. By violent ends, we kill the light. Through the shadows, madness beckons. Weird at night.
Freed from the shackles of time and space, we present Weird at
What's up, everybody? It's your band, the Big O. I want to encourage you to tune in to Weird at Night right here on Converge Media every Saturday at 10 p.m.
Hello, weirderinos, weirdos, weirdites, deadlies, chat cherubs, and welcome to the place that streams with this digital face. Welcome to the daytime of the night. Welcome to the special land inside your mind, where parrots are 8 feet tall and kitty cats are the size of donkeys. Welcome to the one and the only Weird at Night. I'm Patrick Galactic, and I'll be your guide tonight for this incredible and extra special hour-ish expedition through music, animation, and much, much more. And why? Why is tonight extra special, you may ask? Why tonight of all nights should this stream of digital consciousness be where I lay my withering attention span? Well, because tonight, after the fallout of last week's electric debate of science versus medicine, everyone turned their attention to the real story. Who is the Barefoot Messiah, and why are the people of Noirland flocking to him? We're going to find out in just a few minutes, mon amis. But we have Spaceship Trucker raiding with a party of seven. Fantastic. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, everyone. But before we can get to that, we, you know, kind of have this. Well, shit. We got to get the Corpse Cosmos resurrected because we got so too much time and too little to do. Wait, strike that. We must purify the soul of the WAN-iverse, and the only way to do it, we must regale the faintest glimmer of light. We must sing the night its bedtime song. We must serenade the stars with a song of the cosmos. Join me and Gizmo now. Throw your Gizmo emotes in the chat so I know you're singing along. So I know you're singing along. All right, let's do it. Let's see, did it work? Whoa, we're back! We're in color and the atmosphere is purified! Thank you, my chat cherubs, thank you very much. So last week, we had the epic debate of science versus medicine, and before that, a ton happened. So, if you missed it, here's a little catch-up.
Are you sure this is going to work? I watched the summit between the space raccoons and the trash force. These things can get pretty chaotic.
Terry, take it away.
Yes.
Thank you, Bessie. Are we ready for a debate?
Are we ready to find out who's telling the truth?
Shit, I'm too fucking high. Fuck!
And what are some of the benefits to going barefoot all the time?
It's not. And are there?
I'm sorry, Doctor, but your answer must be in the form of an answer. Mandy Ravage?
As a scientist, what I know is what I have tested.
Oh! Uh-oh.
Mandy, are you hurt? Officially say that what has happened here today is going to haunt us all for a long time and require extensive therapy. I'm leaving some business cards if you need to get in touch.
Fucked this one up.
Yes, we had the honorable Dr. Basic Gordon moderating appearances by Trey Holiday and Trey Halloween and the Goblin Bird and Dr. Vince Violin going at it tooth and nail. And it all came down to a broken bong, courtesy of Dante, Dartone, and the Spectacle Bear. You can watch the full debate on our YouTube channel. I'm dropping the link to that in the chat if you missed it. It was quite the thing. Want to say hello to Spaceship Trucker and the Raiders that just showed up. If you haven't checked them out yet, make sure you... Oh, boy. Spaceship Trucker. Ha-ha! Make sure you go give a follow over to Spaceship Trucker. It's an awesome feed, awesome stream. Make sure you check him out. Now prepare yourself to surrender to the confusion and let the absurdity elucidate your unconscious. To do that, I need you to turn rationality off, and I need you to turn what the fuck to 11. This cosmic calamity ain't an accident, cowpoke. It's an art extravaganza of galactic proportion. Where Tonight is a weekly art voyage through the stars. We love music. We love surreal comedy. Where Tonight is like a smoky patchwork quilt with Twilight Zone, 90s public access TV, Pee-wee's Playhouse, and Reading Rainbow all stitched in. We're astonishingly wholesome for people who say fuck as often as we do here. More importantly than all that, though, we're a show-munity. The chat is 100% where it's at. Some of the stuff we'll be showing tonight was made by somebody hanging out in the chat. So give thanks to... give thanks to... Slow Mouse, sorry. Dante, the ruler of hell and beyond, because you're chatting amongst royalty. Because you're chatting amongst royalty. If you love something you see tonight, make sure you say so, because you can make someone's very weird night even better. And don't fear the darkness, darling, we're weird. It's night and you're in the right place. Respect for each other and the flow of the show is essential. Distractors and spammers will be ejected. All right, let the art extravaganza begin. And we begin tonight with just a little bit of news. You are currently watching the last episode of Weird at Night before our spring break-ish. We'll be gone for a few weeks, spit shining this place, changing up the look, fiddling with our pocket calculators before Find Your Weird returns on Tuesday, March 28th, and Weird at Night returns Saturday, April 1st. April Fools, mother lovers! But stay tuned to our social media and to our YouTube. I'll be uploading archive clips and full episodes as we go to try and get the rest of our 239 episode archive live. Ugh, that's sexual corn. How could Weird at Night get weirder? It can, and it will. That is something I am very confident of. But stay tuned, as I said, to our social media and our YouTube. I'm dropping those links in the chat right now. Boop. Yes, I'll be uploading archive clips and full episodes as we go to try and get that archive live. Perspective comes with a healthy mind and just a bit of distance. We're coming back weirder and bolder than ever. A new look, new sets, a whole new weird. So while you chew on that, open up once again, but don't choke, because I have a question for you. Boo. How do you escape yourself? How do you escape yourself? I want to know. Just give me an answer. How do you escape yourself? It can be a funny answer. It can be a serious answer. But I want to hear from you guys. Yes. How do you escape yourself? All right, we're about to get up close and personal with the Barefoot Messiah, but we've also got music videos from AJ Suede, Javon, and Haunted Horses for you tonight, plus public access insanity, and much more. But as I said, we're about to get up close and personal with the Barefoot Messiah, a cult-like figure who's convinced much of the Noirland populace to go shoeless, yet someone who apparently hates being shoeless himself. Have you ever heard of a guru doing the opposite of what they tell their followers to do? That's wacky. That's a new one to me. And what is his connection to the monocle bear who appears to have hypnotized Tony Japan, Bang Bang the Gun Safety Butterfly, and Louie to join him? Hopefully, we find out. Now, we present to you the Barefoot Messiah.
Yes, I can lift over 50 pounds. Oh God. Where are we going?
The streets of Noirland smell just like they used to. Smells fishy. And one word is in the mouths of every detective in Noirland PD. A word that was first born as a working title. A word that became a machine. A word that I used to name the double knot special I tie my laces with each and every day. The word echoes through these streets. Utopian. 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 She got away. Stolen during the trial of Dartone. While the entire city was focused on justice, someone was stealing Utopian. It couldn't have been Dartone. He was getting murdered and unmurdered at the time. I would suspect the Goblin Bird, but they were making a deal with Dante to normalize the climate within the WAN-iverse. It must be a mystery. Mysteries are what I do. I get to the bottom of them. I sniff out questions and I ask more. Answers happen to me, but I don't know how. It reminds me of a pair of soft shoe yellow heels. The left shoe was missing, and I could never find the right suspect. It seems someone had called my client before I had arrived, presented themselves as me, said they were finding lost shoes. That's my beat, Jack. I never did find that heel. But who was the other shoe detective? Who placed that call? Was it Tony Japan? Could it have been my doppelganger all along? One step ahead of me, finding the shoes, stealing Utopian. But why? Why the fuck would Tony Japan do this?
What's in there?
That's not something you need to concern yourself with. The less you know, the better, mate.
You make it sound like it's something dangerous.
Truth of it is, you better play sick with me. If the monocle bear catches you snooping about, there's no telling how far he might fry your brains. You could be barefoot for life. Now come on. We've got to hurry. The Barefoot Messiah has called everyone together for a team meeting. Oi, attention please, but where? I give you our fearless leader, an inspirational conspirator, the Barefoot Messiah!
God damn it, Frank! I appreciate a theatrical entrance, but that overkill on the smoke machine.
Noted, my lord. Less smoke machines.
Hello, and thank everyone for attending the meeting. The plan is a bit complicated, but I just want you to make sure that we get off on the right foot. You should laugh at that. Frank, who is that?
That is Tony. Tony Japan, my lord.
who the fuck is Tony Japan? A doppelganger of Pete Germany? Interesting. That could be useful. Good work. Will everyone here pay close attention? Especially you, Tony Japan. We're going to save Norland once and for all. Bang Bang Butterfly, the gun sciences specialist, has provided us with necessary firepower. Louis, the strange dog who owns the local waterhole, has provided us with cash. I prepared the path for us to rule the entire WAN-iverse. And you will walk in the path with me. And we will step on anyone who gets in our way. Any questions?
I feel morally conflicted, my lord. We exist to protect the fate of Noirland. It doesn't seem fair for us to step on their rights, does it? If some of them don't believe, don't we have to respect that?
You need to respect me. You need to respect the plan. The feet of this city has walked on us for a few months. We've been working underground to bring their dreams to life while they ignorantly step on our heads. They walked on you first. They ran into the streets and killed your parents.
Why? What did he say? What? Killed his parents.
They deserve whatever it is we bring to them. And I expect every piece of footwear of Tony Japan or whatever the fuck they want to call themselves. Get in the line. Muscle Bear, please make my point clear for anyone else who doesn't understand.
Yes, Messiah! We will do what you ask! Our barefoot leader is right! New Orleans must pay!
The shooting detectives must pay!
Oi!
That's more like it! Move out! Not you, Monocle Bear. I need to see you in my office.
The Barefoot Messiah is arming his shoes? Who've been hypnotized by the Monocle Bear to take Noirland by force? Good God! This makes Dartone's time as the savior look like a bad episode of Mr. Rogers! And what was in that room that had all the electricity coming out of it? And when the fuck is Steve Germany gonna get out of flashback and try to do something? The WAN-iverse is in peril and the Barefoot Messiah's power seems to be growing! I still don't understand what the Monocle Bear's tie to the Messiah is, but it's obviously treacherous! We'll have more from the Barefoot Messiah later tonight! Scary. I gotta calm down. Noirland may be on the brink of disaster, but we have a show to do. Take a breath. Take another. Okay. You see, holy fuck, the Barefoot Messiah is coming! The Barefoot Messiah is coming! Watch this dope music video from dope Seattle rapper Javon because it's dope and no one uses pastels and kitty cats as dope as Javon!
Javon, aka Cool Sweater, you should do better. The truth has zero friends and got his ass whipped. Better yet, you better move before it's you on the stretcher. YouTube views is lesser. Don't trip, I gave a cool effort. Still move better. Letterman on his troops is checkered. His movement started it and it seems lit. To be disillusioned is the mark of a genius. Only true anime, but the art was seen it. He moved on what his tongue didn't say, but his heart would mean it. No exaggeration. How niggas claim to be real when they just figments of a hyperactive imagination. Target me. I filter data like artery. The reflection in the mirror is hardly me. Yeah, they live apart from me, but still claim a part of me. They need proof, right? Try to do things for truth's sake. The truth takes its time and people refuse to wait. Still I move straight. Yeah, and sadness filled the room, bumping MF Doom's doomsday. My wish them truth. Shaka and Abdul, my niggas from Deuce. Ain't seen them in a minute, I hope my dues stay. Niggas ask me how I lose faith, paying all my dues before the due date. I guess I gotta just find a new way. For the love you better like LL Cool J. For the love you better like LL Cool J.
Good night, Funny Bones. My little star.
Good night.
Good night.
Compass rose, a special drawing that clearly shows north, south, east, west. Oh, compass rose, you're the best. Your four cardinal directions are why you'll always be a star. Compass rose, a special drawing that clearly shows north, south, east, west. Oh, compass rose, you're the best.
Good night, little buddy. I'll tuck you in. Mwah. Oh.
Conversation, rhetoric thrown over forced demonstration. Oh no, y'all ain't gon' monkey with shit. Fall in the line or get blinded by myths. On God, bust with the time and the Midas touch. Vest and survive in a giant bluff. Might as well sever that dire trust in doing your job when it's not enough. We just gon' go, do what I like. We don't suppose, true to this life. Cheap in the clothes, to open my eyes. We keep in the soul and to show it the light. Maybe they turn it off, flipping the switches. Tripping by digits and tricking they misses. Shatterton's rickety, breaking them bitches. And spinning them bitches and pointing their fingers.
That was a lovely little video from Javon. It's called Cool Sweater, and it's really fucking amazing, isn't it? Wasn't that fun? I took what the doctor gave me for anxiety during our little break, and I'm feeling a lot better. Javon is one of my favorite artists because we featured here, and I highly recommend you go check out his Bandcamp, his YouTube, and whatever else of his you'd like. Give him some money because money's nice, right? Yeah. Oh, and who is that little silly face singing about our rose compass? Our rose compass is lovely. I just want to eat him right up. And that last clip you saw was a track called Negotiate by a group called Retnam, featuring the one and only Monster of Ceremonies, Terry Monstrosity. Make sure you follow their links too. Follow them, you little cutie pies. So I asked, how do you escape yourself? I asked you guys how you do it, and you little sweethearts gave me answers. Maddie O'Shea says, listen to music. Yeah, that's good. I listen to music. Isn't this lovely little music right now? Thanks, Maddie O'Shea. Sexual Corn makes the very true statement that it's impossible to escape oneself. Intrinsic to one's experience is having one's faculty. There is no hope, but it is not hopeless. Very well said, Sexual Corn. Thanks. Thanks. Alex FNV. I escape myself by watching a show or movie or getting lost in a book. That's really nice, Alex. That's really nice. And Dartone the Third says, I escape myself by sneaking into WAN subscribers' houses and organizing their shoes and cleaning their kitchens and teach their pets commands.
in Arabic.
you little jokesters. You're so funny.
Wow, those anxiety pills hit hard when you first take them. Ooh, I'm feeling better. I'm back. Okay, wow. Well, something else that makes me feel better is Converge Media. Converge stars Basa Gordon and Deaunte Damper, whose voice might sound slightly familiar, recently were hosts at the GSBA Impact Awards. If you don't know, GSBA is Washington State's LGBTQ+ and Allied Chamber of Commerce. It is the largest of its kind in North America, and it was very, very epic, super epic. Seriously, check this out. Have a look.
Hey, I'm Deaunte Damper.
And I'm Basa Gordon.
And welcome to the GSBA Impact Awards.
First of all, it's a GSBA event, so you know everything is going to be over the top. We have living statues. We have a girl in a whole champagne dress. Like, I pulled this off of someone's outfit, okay? We have performances and all of the community people that have just truly made such impacts in the room right now.
I'm so happy to be at the GSBA Awards just to celebrate an opportunity for community to come together and celebrate the fact that even though we're all different and we come from different walks of life, different queer experience, we can have fun together and celebrate how we're the same and the causes that we come together to support.
Man, there's a lot going on here tonight. This is an exciting time, you know? Here supporting the GSBA, where they're giving out awards for people that are doing great things in our community, supporting great causes. And again, I'm just honored to be here and be amongst the great people here tonight.
Businesses that give back to the community, community leaders, nonprofits, those who step out, step up, and make a difference in our community.
So our goal is really to support any businesses that have maybe been left out in the past. Black-owned, BIPOC-owned, veteran-owned, women-owned, and also in rural communities where it's really hard to access some of these services and funding that a lot of folks in underrepresented communities have been left out in the past.
Tonight was really awesome getting to see Basa. I'm really excited once the doors open to see her MC tonight. And then even getting to see Lewis from Ezels and getting to see our community be here in this space and be celebrated is really awesome.
I want to welcome everybody to the 2022 GSBA Impact Award.
It's all about celebrating and really building each other up, and we're just really excited to be a part of it.
They're a resource for the entire community all the time, always on top of the ball, and really working with all aspects of the community and all sorts of different businesses in ways that they can motivate help from, you know, social media down to grants that are available.
I feel really fortunate that we have people of color that are working with GSBA who are reaching out and trying to bring other people of color on board. And honestly, if it wasn't for people looking out for each other and bringing community in, I wouldn't have even known that, like, GSBA was a thing that I could personally be a part of.
Support each other, support small business, volunteer, give back, because it fills your heart and soul. When people say, how do you have the energy? I want to say, how do you not? How do you not?
Hey everybody, it's me, Don, from Don's Long Gone Lawns. I take acid and play with knives. Got a lawn too far gone.
Ron here from Lawns Owned by Ron. Here to remind you that rent is due. And no, it's not payable in acid.
Well. A lot going on there. Very cool about the Converge at the GSBA Awards. Deaunte Damper and Basa Gordon. Very, very cool stuff. Sexual Corn thinks they've met Don from Don's Long Gone Lawns, the lawn knife acid guy. You just well may have. I've met some people who are very similar to Don from Don's Long Gone Lawns. Just if you're joining us right now, just want to communicate to some of you that you are watching the last live episode of Weird at Night until April 1st. We will be back with Find Your Weird on Tuesday, March 28th. But until then, we're going to be taking a little time off to retool, refresh, make things a little weirder, get things back in order, and just make Weird at Night even better than it already is. Thank you all for your support. But yes, it's good. It's good to get some perspective. It's good to step back for a minute. It's good to refresh. But you can join our Discord. I think we'll probably have a live chat or two during the break. I might pop in there for a minute and chat with you all on some random night. Not sure, but I'd like to. Also, want to remind you, we have a shop, the shop of Weird at Night, the shop of WAN, and our featured artist in this little promo break here is Blazin' Space. We have an artist studio in our shop. I dropped the link in the chat just now. And the artist studio is really cool because artists like Blazin' Space, Not For Sale, Terry Monstrosity, and a bunch of others have merch over there. And when you buy something there, all the profits from those purchases go directly to those artists. You can make a big difference for artists. You know, anybody who is in the professional art game knows that it's high cost, time intensive, and sometimes extremely expensive. And, you really do have to get support from people. This is a way that you can support the artists that you see here on Weird at Night that you love. We have a bunch more in the chat. In the artist studio, we have a bunch more that you can check out as well. We got TC Blackout in the house. Better Kitty Meow. Sexual Corn. Freddy Dalmastar. Alex F and V. Spaceship Trucker. Hidden Histories. Hey, Hidden Histories. Good to see you. We got a great group tonight. I'm having a blast. I'm definitely looking forward to having a little break. I won't lie. I mean, this is it's a labor of love, friends, and it's very time intensive. So I'm looking forward to being able to clear my brain out so we can figure out a way to be even weirder, even more experimental, even more interactive, whatever it is. We're going to do it. So if you have ideas, you can let us know in our Discord. Also, while we're gone, if you want to do some auto writes, in our Discord, we actually have an auto write channel now, and people have been making some use of it. I've made use of it. Euphony of the Month has made use of it. I believe Sexual Corn has made use of it. So go to our Auto Write channel. You don't have to skip out on the Auto Writes just because Weird at Night isn't live. Blazin' Space said, at first I didn't have an answer to the question, but then I realized that I was also currently eating a pop brownie. Very nice, Blazin' Space. Very nice. Very on brand for Blazin' Space. Dartone the Third. I was trying to jump into something. TC Blackout says, Don equals cool, Ron equals not cool. Dartone the Third says, I was in a house share with Don. Don't eat his food. Trust me. Sexual Corn then says, because of the food or because of Don? And then Dartone said, Don, he doesn't play around with weak old pizza. Yes. Yes. And Sexual Corn then says, can't blame Don there. That's about vintage for pizza. Imagine having to order pizza again and needing to wait another week. Fair. Fair. Now, we have a whole lot more coming at you. So, we're gonna get started. Coming up, we've still got a ton coming your way, friends. Not For Sale, AJ Suede, Haunted Horses, and so much more. So much more, but now it's time to go back to the WAN-iverse and learn more about the ruthless Barefoot Messiah. Oh, God.
Now, when we met, we had an agreement, and I expected you to fulfill your end of the bargain to the fullest. I gave you what you asked for. You are the most recognized spectacle bear in all of WAN-iverse. There's a bar named after you. They're selling t-shirts, tote bags with your face on them. Now I need you to keep your shoes in line, make sure my followers stay pleasantly convinced and devoted to my plan, the plan, to make sure nothing else is lost again.
Barefoot Messiah, may I have a word below?
God damn it, Frank! Fine, Monskill Bear, we'll finish this shit later. What is it, Frank?
Wimmy Lord, I'm just a bit worried about the plan. As mysterious as Norlan is, and as much faith as I have in my Barefoot Messiah, I must say, an army of foot soldiers carrying firearms into the city of Enigma could have, well, predictably tragic consequences. Are we the good guys here?
Frank, let me tell you a story. A story about a man who found himself responsible for sewing the fragments of this society together. Now, this is before Dartone teamed up with the space raccoons. Since I can remember, my family ran Normyline Lost and found a nonprofit dedicated to picking up the lost clues and filling the potholes left behind by Normyline Mysteries. Yes, this is Normyline Lost and Found. Well, where did you last see the shoe? Okay, great. Sounds like you found it. Happy to help. Excuse me, what are you two doing here?
Well, here to arrest the owner of this operation.
That would be me.
You're under arrest.
This is an outrage. This is a travesty.
There's one sewer detective in this town, and that's sewer detective Steve Dermody. You're being arrested under vigilante sewer detective detective-ing.
They would arrest me, release me. I would start up the lost and found again, and they'd arrest me again. And again, and again, and again. Each time, Steve Germany would not acknowledge me, not once. Here I was, the man who actually, in finding Normyland's lost shoes, the man would come and not even recognize me. The irony. Did he not know that I existed? Did he even realize that our past and our futures were linked? Frank, my past with Steve Germany goes back further than you can even know. What I can tell you right now is he lives because I'm merciful. The 15 times they brought me in, I didn't even want to go home. I had given up. There was no point of being free when there was no place I'd rather be. So I stayed in that cell, and I learned from the lost citizens of Norland. I don't know how much time passed. Days, months, years. Raccoonon and the Trash Force were disbanded, and Dartone the Third became the savior of the WAN-iverse. Many loyal Dartone followers passed through the Norland cells, and I listened to their stories about the savior and his vague theories. All of the Norland PD had left the station for the trial of Dartone, and I was left all alone. And then, Frank, it happened.
The ground is shaking, the other is putting it through.
Suddenly, I had everything that I needed to restore order where there was chaos. Create utopias where Steve Germany had destroyed our lives. So, you should be grateful that I stole Utopian so I could give you life.
Are we the good guys here?
Yes, we're the good guys. Now, get back to work.
Yes, sir.
Choose.
Thank you.
Wow. I did not expect that. The Barefoot Messiah was a do-gooder, lost-and-found charity person? That was arrested time and time again corruptly by Suave and Pickle on behalf of Noirland PD Chief and Shoe Detective Steve Germany? Who slowly gave up hope and decided to go a new way with the Monocle Bear? And the Monocle Bear's big stake in this is fame and money? What? And they stole Utopian? That is how they're making the shoes sentient? Is that why Tony Japan was rounding up all the shoes in Noirland to create an army? Well, it certainly appears to be the case, yeah. And it appears the dark and mysterious road of the Barefoot Messiah will conclude when we return on Saturday, April 1st. Oh my God. Just 3 weeks to live in terror and fear for me, no biggie. But you know what is a biggie? Shitties! Shitties Pizza! The hospital is right next door. If you don't know why, just have a slice. Use promo code WHYGODDOWESUFFER. You get a free deep pubing. Normally $4.99. Not for you. Not for you, Weirded Night viewers. No, you get a pube-free pizza absolutely free when you use the promo code WHYGODDOWESUFFER. And that's not all. You can shave and save. That's right. When you use that promo code, we'll use the scraped pubes from your pizza to make you and your family a complimentary Merkin. Yeah, who doesn't want that? It's on the corner of Ninth and Nocturnal Drive, just past the memory of your first fully charged smartphone. All right, while we celebrate pube-free pizza, it's time we celebrate once again the incredible artistry of Seattle rapper AJ Suede. The Suede God has been featured many times here on Weird at Night because he is one of the most authoritative voices in Seattle hip-hop, and I can't resist. This video is called Waterbed. You see what I mean?
You already know what time it is. Dark Suede, yeah. Know what I mean? You want it, I got it. They poison in the water. Or some favor guns over systematic slaughter. Critter for the arsenic. Critters turn to carcasses. Rather cops would drip from Neiman Marcus's stockroom. Any boxes falling off the back of a truck. You should package it up and get right back to us. Types of hate to see a nigga at the front of the bus. Swear to God you can trust. I'ma fold your shit up like a wallet. What's the word? Sway can't call it. Give a crash dummy hydraulics. Get you bounce out of here. First one to go like Boromir. You don't get to make it through the movie. Got to keep it bluesy. Same way my big cousin Scooby probably had some financial water bet. Listening to Portishead, putting fire reds to the leaf greens. Did all of that without a street team. Street dreams, reign of the kingpin short-lived. Way before phones went cordless. Looking over gorgeous, my shorty looking gorgeous. Wonder why my ego's so enormous. Acid trips killed it on the monthly. Fools too comfy. Barely even reaching out monthly. Type of shit got you feeling crunchy. Damn. Know what I mean?
Oh, hi, this is Dante, the ruler of hell and beyond, with my new toy, Dartone the Third. If you need some of that fresh lettuce, you came to the right place. If you want to make a deal, you called the right face. That rhymes. You are watching Weird at Night.
Hidalgo, Querétaro.
bota más picuda, ¿no? Yeah. A ver, pero póngase de perfil para que vean que no es sí, sí. trucada la patada no, como en las luchas.
Es derecho.
¡Sácale! No, no, no. Mucha suerte. Bueno, que Dios los bendiga.
Hoy que tú quieres volver a mí, ya no se puede, yo ya estoy feliz. Ya tengo quien te reemplace a ti, y este amor sí es bueno para mí.
You know, it is super difficult to sound as dreamy and hard simultaneously as AJ Suede does on the regular, but he does it yet again! The Suede God is always dropping new stuff. Make sure to follow him on YouTube and Bandcamp and buy some shit. He's absolutely worth your dollars, homies. Big shout out to Dante, the ruler of hell and beyond. Something I didn't mention because I was too shocked and pants pissy was that shot of Dante at the very end of the video we last saw of the Barefoot Messiah. Wonder what that's about? Probably just an insanely interesting coincidence, maybe, probably. And lastly, big ups to the homies at Found Footage Fest for that really fascinating performance called Super Cheeto. They got tons more over there. Make sure you check that out and enjoy, because they're swimming in hilarious footage like that. Found Footage Fest is incredible. Something that is less funny and is the dissonant aggression of Seattle industrial punk group Haunted Horses. These cats make loud and scary noise, which, considering everything else we've seen tonight, seems appropriate. This video is called The Garden.
Thank you.
So yeah, that was a lovely way to close things out. TC Blackout said, dope, but I'm probably going to be up for a while after seeing this. Still dope nonetheless. Yes. Dartone the Third says, now I know what to show kids before bed when I'm nannying. I agree. Why not? Why not, friends? Why not? Well, we arrive at the very end of this episode, and it's time for the auto write. What is the auto write? It's a tool of the surrealists where I count back from 10. As I do, you try to clear your mind. When I get to 1, I'm going to say go. When I say go, we all start tippity-tippity typing whatever comes into your mind. And then after about 30 or 45 seconds, I say stop. We all hit enter, return on the keyboard. Everybody's auto write shows up in the chat. And we read them out loud. We go, you silly prankster. And then we get the hell out of here. So, once again, I'm going to count back from 10 as I do. Try to clear your mind. When I get to 1, I'm going to say go. When I say go, we all start tippity-tippity typing whatever comes into our minds. After about 30 or 45 seconds, I'll say stop. Then we hit enter or return. And then we read them. And then the world will be healed. Okay, let's do it. Take a deep breath. Okay. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Start typing. All right, and stop. Go ahead and hit enter return on your keyboard. I dropped mine into the chat. I will start reading that while we wait for more. Okay. When the clock strikes 13, that means it's me and the old sandwich I found in the mud again. Just us, two of us wearing raincoats. It's a sandwich that I dropped long ago and couldn't justify using the 5-second rule with, so I didn't. But it haunts me, taunts me. I'm sorry, sandwich. I'm sorry. Great job, me. Blaze in space. Within the tear of a clown, an ocean tide shifts, and under the depths, three mice talk of tomorrow's journey with the cricket, the one with the human face and the bee eyes. The bee eyes like diamonds that show you all of your possible deaths, none of which will happen to you if you can catch the cricket. You must catch him with your ears. Listen carefully to the dream. Blaze in space, wow. I need to catch the cricket, holy shit. Spaceship Trucker, is this healthy? She said, pointing to a very abnormal bulge in her abdomen. Are we in an alien movie? I thought, or yeah, this is clearly just a dream. Very nice, Spaceship Trucker. Well done. TZ Blackout, analog to digital because my digits are stubs. Damn the frostbite which occurred during my single opportunity to visit the tropicals. Botanical to manacle, I finally understand Swamp Thing. Maybe. Excellent, TC Blackout. Excellent. Alex F and V, get outside and pick up a beanbag chair today. Put a kitten on it. Watch it burn the world to the ground because this is the apocalypse, baby. I didn't know it was coming, but I've started it now, and you're never going to guess the catalyst to a wild bird's feathers. Cookie Monster! Happy birthday, Pat, you filthy bitch. Thank you, Alex F and V. Better Kitty Meow, Unicorn Sparkles and Joan Jett live in a rainbow wonderland of fresh vegetables and hiding places, but want to come out from hiding, to which you, the happiest of cumpleaños in over an hour. Well, thank you, Better Kitty Meow, and Unicorn Sparkles and Joan Jett. I'll get to a little more of that in just a minute. Sexual Corn, I was 8th floor, Hard to get apartment, work from home, typing away, for forums, for scripting, for programming, for bug hunting, the sun shifting its angle in my windows until the streetlights from below took it over. And I noticed this anomaly, some figure on a bench at the concrete, staring up, some human same time of day and nice, with a sack of food sat next to it, would stare up ceaselessly, even as I stood down and even as I stared at them, and they noticed they didn't stop. An old joke. Sexual corn. Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Dartone the Third. I was teaching my cousin's kid how to make pipe bombs. The key is to have someone else build them. They blow up super easy. Like, really, don't make them. This is the only time I will give good advice. Now, a bottle of vodka and a rag? God damn it. FBI, get out of my house. Dartone. Thank you for making me say that. Live on a stream, Dartone. I really appreciate that. Really appreciate that. Sexual corn continued. In dorms, someone walks in on you during polishing the family jewels. You're a pervert, and if they remain as you continue, they're the pervert. Where is the border, and what does it mean when it continues? So I wanted to control back the power, a one-upsmanship. So I stood on my chair, naked, nipples, proud. Sexual corn, fantastic. Fantastic. And I want to say, in 1 hour, on the West Coast and already on the East Coast, it's my birthday. Thank you, Alex FMV, for the birthday wishes. Thank you, Better Kitty Meow, for the birthday wishes. Thank you, Unicorn Sparkles and Joan Jett, the guinea pigs, for their birthday wishes. And this has been an absolute blast to spend it with you all. Thank you all so much. It's that time for Enderoos. We've learned who the Barefoot Messiah is, and it's not as simple as it might have seemed. Shocking that. We've got a huge finale coming up on April 1st when we return. But right now, we've got a spring break coming up, and I'm looking forward to recharging and refreshing. I'm sure Blazing Space is too. But working on Weird at Night. Looking forward to making it even weirder, even more interactive, even sillier stream than it already is. I assure you, we will be back with some new looks and feels when we return. Find Your Weird comes back Tuesday, March 28th, and Weird at Night returns with the epic finale of the Barefoot Messiah's Path on Saturday, April 1st. April Fools! Who will be the fool? Steve Germany? I mean, more than he already is? The Barefoot Messiah? Or literally everyone else? Join us on April 1st to find out. Thank you all for the birthday wishes. Seriously, so much. Thank you. Weird at Night is founded on 4 key principles. People come first. Time matters more than money. Art is the antidote. Attack with love. And love yourself because you're the best thing that's ever going to happen to you. I'm Patrick Galactic. We are Weird at Night. Take good care of you and love your people every chance you get. I'm going to be in Discord around 11:30 p.m. Pacific tonight for about 30 minutes. I'll be back in this big chair on Tuesday, March 28th. Till then, mon amis, thank you so much for being Weird at Night. Let's be real.
right after now.
Wherever you go, there you are.